This tutorial is part of our Building a Python Package course, where we learn how to build, test, and automate deployment of a Python Django middleware package to the Python package index. You can watch the entire course uninterrupted, ad-free, and access updated tutorial source code and other resources from our Udemy course. Now, alternatively, you can access the course via our YouTube playlist. This features tutorials from the course. Links to the YouTube course and YouTube playlist can be found in the video description. Next up, we're going to learn how to create a Django model. If you're not familiar with Django models, very briefly, let's just describe this as the way of creating and managing database tables. We're going to need to create a Django model so that we can create a query on that table so that we can then capture those queries in the terminal. If you're not familiar with SQL queries, terminals, and such, don't worry, this will unfold throughout this course. So back into our terminal here, I'm just going to command K that, clear that. Right, so we're going to need to build a model. So I can close this now, in actual fact, the terminal. Let's go back in and close the settings file. And then we go into the SQL query. Remember, this is the app that we're building. So let's go into the models. So here we're now going to create a new model. Now remember, essentially, we're just describing a table that's going to be created in the database, and then we can manage within this model.py file. So for this, we need to create a new class. So this is going to be the name of our table. So let's just call this product, for example. So we're just going to create a table. Now remember, all this so far, the naming of the project, the naming of the app, this is just made up so that we can build an application just to showcase capturing SQL queries in the terminal to give you some context as to why and what middleware we are creating for the rest of this course. So let's just call this product, and we're going to extend from models, so models.model. So we're just bringing in the tool so we can then go ahead and describe the fields that we're going to create on this table. So we're going to have a name field, name equals models, dot, and we need to describe the field type, character field. And then there is a mandatory requirement for us to specify the max length of this. So let's say 100 characters. So it just means that this field will have a format or data type of character field. That means we're constrained to the requirements of a character field. And then we're going to then specify a max length of 100. So in this field in our database, we can store up to 100 characters inside of this field. Right, so like I said, it's kind of irrelevant, but it gives you a little bit of a background if you are new to Django. So models dot, let's create a slug field for this. So give us a max length of 102. And then finally, let's just go for a Boolean. So is digital. So maybe some of our products will be digital products. We just need to specify that, because we might want to handle them differently. So this is going to be a Boolean field. And then we're going to have a default here of false. So that's the default option. If we don't specify this field, we're going to have a default value of false. What's going to store that within the record that we create. Now, what we can also do is just return, when we return any of these objects, have some sort of user-friendly name to describe the object, so we can return the name. So if I returned an object, a record from this table, and I inspected it, it would have, will be referenced by the name of that particular product. And that makes it easy for me to identify what object, what row I've returned from the database. So once I've created a new model, I need to migrate that. I actually need to insert that action this into the database, because at the moment, this table doesn't exist. So there's no need for me to set up a database here. Django's done that for me automatically, already defined in the settings. And in addition to that, it will be creating an SQLite database, which is a file-based database. So there's no additional installs here. It's just going to create a file. All the data is going to be installed. All the data is going to be stored in this file. Now, don't worry if you don't have this file here. You may not. Let's go ahead now and make migrations. So for this, I'm going to use the management command. And then I just need to tell Django to prepare a migration. So make migrations. Okay, so what's happened now is it's inspected this code here that we've just generated. It's created a new file here, a preparation file, which can then be utilized and converted into SQL code and then sent to the database so it can then create the tables. So now I just need to go back into the terminal here and just type in manage.py and then migrate. So it's now going to actually action this file and migrate everything over. So in my database now, I should have this new table. Now to inspect the SQLite database, it cannot be done natively. We need to install a third-party extension. So on the left-hand side, open up your extensions, type in SQLite, and then install this extension. I've already installed it, so there will be an install option here for you if you haven't installed it. And then once you've done that, you can go back to Explorer here. You can then right-click, open the database. It appears at the bottom. You can't see it. Let me bring it up. Looks a bit like that, SQLite, and that's your database right there. So what you can do is you can open it up and then inspect all the tables. So these are all the tables that Django has made through performing that migration, because Django already has a lot of other applications in the settings here. You can see all these different applications are installed by default. These are all the tables that will support all this functionality. So we created a new table called product. So you can see here, Django uses the name of the app and then the name that we provided as the class to actually name the table. And if you go inside of that, you can then see all the fields that we've created. But these are all the tables, all the fields that we created. Now at the moment, I can right click and show the table. And you can see there's no rows, there's no data inside of this table yet. So that's a quick overview then of creating a new Django model and actually then inspecting that data. Now, obviously there's no data in it at the moment, but we'll add that or populate that later on in this section of the course.